Hi everybody, this is Nick. I got a great viewer question on one of our videos about how to fill custom shapes with photos and using sort of the crop tools behind the scenes to make sure that those photos aren't squished and stretched within whatever custom shape you're doing. But I got a great question from Christina who said, is there a way to combat the stretching issue when the shape you're trying to fill with an image is a letter? The crop option isn't available for text, just the box around it. So this is a really great question, Christina. I'm going to escape out of this slide and we're going to go over to our demonstration slide right here. Let's just say we're doing a presentation about pandas. I have a nice big chunky text, pandas, as my title on the text here. Now, if I wanted to fill the text with a picture, I could do that just by going to the Format Shape menu. So I right click, click on Format Shape menu. The Format Shape menu pops up, and I want to make sure that you see two things here. Now, you have Shape Options and you have Text Options. If I'm under the Shape Options tab, all I'm doing is formatting the actual text box, the box around the text. But if I go over here to Text Options, this is where I can go ahead and update the text fill color. Right now it's black, but maybe I want it to be blue. But this is also where you can go ahead and fill it with a gradient, or you can fill it with a picture. So let's go ahead and click on Picture, and I'm going to go ahead and click on Insert. You can see that I've already been playing with this, so it's going to give me kind of a picture that I was already playing with. But I'm going to say from stock images, if you had a picture from files or something like that that you wanted to use, you could do that as well. So I'm going to go ahead in my stock images and just type in panda, and I'm going to go ahead and click on this image right here, a nice big face of a panda, insert, and now you can see that it fills that text with that photo. Now it might look just a tiny bit stretched, and the thing that you might be able to do too is click on this little tile picture as texture. If you do that, it's going to fill the photo even more, and then you don't really get that much of the actual photo behind the scenes. So I tend not to really like that option right here. I'm gonna uncheck it so that it goes away. But if we want to make sure that things aren't stretched, usually I would go up to the crop menu, but there's no crop menu because the photo isn't there. So if I go to the shape format menu, I don't see my crop. Usually a picture format tab would pop up and then I could go ahead and crop some things. So what we have to do is effectively turn this text into a shape. So let's go ahead and do that, all using the merge shapes tool. So the first thing we want to do is insert a rectangle. So I'm going to insert this rectangle, put it right over that text box. I'm going to send it to the back, right click and say send to back. And what we want to make sure is that the border of the text box is all inside the border of the big rectangle that I just put here. So we're going to first click on the background. We're going to click on that background rectangle, hold down shift and click on the text. And now let's go up to the merge shapes tools. Now I have this on my quick access toolbar, but you're going to find it under the shape format menu. And then over here under the insert shapes menu, the merge shapes tools. Now what I want to do here is I'm going to actually click on intersect. Now when I click on intersect, that makes everything one shape. All of this text, all of that text now, that word pandas is one single shape. Now if I were to go over to the shape format menu right here, the format shape menu is open. I'm going to go ahead and click picture from text, and now you can see that panda picture is now in the back. I would go ahead and insert the shape if I wanted to do something new, but since I already had that panda picture on my clipboard, that's what it filled it with. And I want to make sure that it's not going to be stretched, so you can go up to the picture format tab. You have access to that, and we're going to go to the crop menu and then make sure that you could click on fill or fit. I'm going to go ahead and say fill, and now it gives you an option to sort of move and drag that crop area behind the scene. So I'm going to hold down shift, make it a little bit bigger, and then I'm just going to drag this down so I can maybe see the eyes, a little bit of the panda right there, and you can reposition the photo in that way, and it's just going to make sure that the photo is nice and proportional. It's not stretched. Click on the crop menu again, and now you have a really nice shape. Now, there's one more little trick here. You can go ahead and resize the text however you want to now that it's a shape. The limitation there is now you can't update the text. You can't edit the text because it's a static shape. So make sure that before you do this, all of the text that you want to turn into a shape is completely final and perfect. So let's go ahead. I'm going to actually bring this text box back. Go back to the text fill options. I'm going to make this text black again. And now what I wanted to do is, what if you just wanted one of the letters to be its own shape and not the entire word? So we're going to do the same thing with the merge shapes tool. I'm going to insert a rectangle and make sure that the rectangle fills that whole area of that text box. We're going to send it to the back. And now what I'm going to do is hold down the shift key on that rectangle, and then hold down and then select the text on top of it. Go back to the merge shapes menu right here, and instead of intersect, I'm going to click on fragment. And what fragment is going to do is basically turn everything that you see here, everything that's overlapping is going to become its own shape. So you'll see what happens right here when I click on fragment. It's kind of like a big cookie cutter. All of the box, the rectangle is still there. If I click on that, that's a single shape. I could delete it, and now you can see we don't have that anymore. But you can also see all the holes within each of the letters is also its own sort of cookie cutter fragmented shape. I'm going to go ahead and delete all those, but now you can see it's not just one, the whole word isn't one big shape, the letters are each individual shape. So now I could go ahead and fill this one single shape with a photo. Woo, you can see that panda is really stretched or squished in like this. Remember, go back to the picture format tab and then crop and then fill. And now that's going to be a nicely fit photo here. Crop right there, and now you have a beautiful kind of customized letter there with a photo in the background. Now, if I wanted to go ahead and just recolor this, I could select all of them, and then we can go back up to that shape format menu. I'm going to fill it with black. Let's see if it's actually not text anymore. I'm not filling the text. I'm filling the shape. So I have to go over here to the shape fill and then fill that with black. And now you have a really nice customized sort of header there with photos or images in the background of the text, a pretty cool technique. So thanks again, Christina, for the question. I appreciate it. If this helps, let me know in the comments below. If any of you out there like this video, give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. Had a great time making this for you. Can't wait to see you next time.